A House lawmaker says adopting the economic amendments to the Constitution will create about 2 million jobs and sustain government efforts to pull down the unemployment rate. According to Aklan Representative Teodorico Haresco Jr., removing foreign investment restrictions in the charter is the lowest hanging fruit for an emerging economy like the Philippines. He adds amending the Constitution will double foreign investments in the country.
The framers of our 1987 Constitution held ang paggawa nila ng Constitution na noon ay inward looking. They were hoping, aspiring that the capital investment required will be generated by Filipinos in the Philippines. So na-realize natin ngayon, from the 9th Congress to the 19th Congress, we do not have enough capital. It takes 1.1 million pesos to create one job. 16 million, 11 million underemployed, another 4 million unemployed. Mga katabi natin mga bansa, nagpalit ng konstitusyon 9 times sa Indonesia, 20 times sa Thailand, Vietnam. So, ayun po, sila outward looking.
Philippine Finance Chief Ralph Recto breezes through his confirmation hearing in Congress. The erstwhile lawmaker was confirmed to the post Wednesday by his former colleagues at the Commission on Appointments. Recto was tapped by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in January to chart the Philippine economy's course to post-pandemic recovery. The Finance Secretary reiterated during the hearing his priorities of increasing tax collection and bringing down consumer prices.
We will continue to employ measures that will shield consumers, especially the vulnerable, from the pain of elevated prices. Inflation is an unlegislated tax the people should not bear. But in my mind, the best way to inculcate tax obedience is still to promote ease of payment and to show that taxes that are efficiently collected are effectively spent.
A province-wide state of calamity could soon be declared in Occidental Mindoro. The Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office made that recommendation, citing the severe damage caused by the El Nino weather phenomenon to the agriculture sector. The cost has now reached 300 million pesos. Several municipalities in the province had earlier been placed under a state of calamity due to the effects of El Nino. A look now at our corporate stories this Wednesday. Ayala Corporation sees its 2023 earnings exceed pre-pandemic levels. Core net income jumped to 41 billion pesos, which the conglomerate says was 32% higher from its 2019 profit. Net income, which accounted for one-offs, also grew to 38.1 billion. Driving once more the strong results were BPI and Ayala Land, as well as its renewable power arm, AC Energy. It's a different picture, though, for Nickel Asia. The Zamora-led mining firm saw its net income last year dwindling by 53% to 3.7 billion pesos. Nickel Asia attributes this to lower nickel ore prices and to losses from equity interests in two processing plants. Now back to the Ayala Group, the real estate arm secures board approval for the merger of Ayala Land with 34 subsidiaries. Ayala Land will become the surviving entity for the planned merger, up for stockholders' vote in April. The undertaking is part of an internal structuring to simplify ownership structures and help ensure efficient funds management. Finally, Globe Telecom completes the pilot run of its hybrid solar power projects in 26 areas. The company is hailing the move as a milestone in its bid for greener network operations. The one-year program focused on solar power integration across 26 Globe sites, three of which are in Metro Manila. Globe says the initiative allowed it to have some 7 million pesos in power consumption.